Hey, what's up, guys? Rob the Jeweler here. Today we got a customer that brought a ring in. I say a customer, it's not really a customer. It's a store, belongs to a store, Cash America to be exact. But they got a ring here that you can see is fractured, split on the bottom. And everything else seems to be intact. It's pretty dirty, but we cleaned it up a little bit so we can work on it. But we're gonna weld that back together today. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna file down our sides, and some of this may seem repetitious, but in jewelry repair, repetitious is everything. The more you do it, the better you get at it. It's like anything else. The more you do, you know, the more you size the ring, the better you get at it. The more you weld, weld a ring together, the better you get at it. Now, you're going to want to practice, if you're just starting out, you want to practice on your jewelry or somebody else's. You're going to mess up. You know, I can do these videos, I can show you, but nobody can really teach you, especially the torch. Nobody can teach you this. You learn what tips, you know, I can tell you, hey, use a 3-tip or 4-tip for smaller items like necklaces, use a 5 or 6 for rings and larger items. But the size of the flame, to adjust it, that stuff you learn on just by doing. You know, you realize what's too hot. And then before you know it, you know exactly kind of what flame you need. But like I've said in previous videos, I suggest that you keep it to start small. Start with a small flame. You always want to be too small, then too big. Don't go big and then work your way down. Start with a small flame. If you have enough heat, crank it up a little bit. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to use our cutting disc to smooth out the sides here. Okay, then we're going to get our crimper pliers and squeeze it together here. Squeeze that together like that. And you want it to meet as flush as possible. As flush as you can get it. The tighter the better. At least that's what he said. Alright. Now we're going to drop this into your denatured boric acid. And we are going to go with a 5-tip on this one. So we're going to put our 5-tip on here. If we can find it. Okay, we're going to go ahead and light this baby up. If our torch will fire up. Sometimes it likes to be a little stubborn. There we go. Go ahead and set the thing on fire. We'll let that denatured alcohol and boric acid burn off. And we're gonna adjust our flame here a little bit. All right. And for all you people out there, a happy 4th of July, which I believe is tomorrow. I haven't looked at the date yet, so I'm kind of, I could be off. And what we're going to do, we're going to cut our solder. This is 10 karat, so we're going to use 10 karat. I'm going to cut us a piece off here. And we just put our flux on the ring there. That was what I was using on the brush, using the flux. And we're going to heat up our solder here. Heat it up. Get it on the tip of the... Then we're going to heat our ring up. Adjust our flame a little bit. And keep it adjusted. Heat this up till it flows, like so. Now you see this smoke that's coming off this thing? Somebody was using a lot of lotion or something that was just caked on the inside of this ring. That's what's burning off. It's not going to hurt it. It just, you know, the cleanup process is a little longer. It's not going to hurt it, but you can see the smoke has died down. But that's what all that smoke is. And it looks like we have went all the way through. We're going to quench it in the water. This is, it does have small little diamonds in it, so we didn't have to worry about the stone shattering. You can see there, those are little itty bitty babies. See if I can get that in the light. I mean, they're tiny. You almost can't even see them. So now what we're going to do is we need to straighten this shank out a little bit. It's a little bit crooked. You can see one side's, you can see how that side is lumping. So we're going to tap it just a little bit, real easy. You ain't got to tap real hard. Use a ball peen hammer. We'll set it over here. Let's see if I can. We'll set it over here on this flat piece, our anvil, little anvil, whatever you want to call it, and just tap like this to get it even. Okay, and then we'll flip it over, do the same thing to the other side. Okay, we're getting there. Jokely, we're almost there. Alright, and just like that, we are straight again. So now, you can see our ring is kind of oblong right now from us having to pull it down to meet together to solder it. So, take your mandrel, we're going to slide it on here. And we're going to push down as far as we can to start with. Like so. Now we're going to tap it with a rubber mallet. Okay. We're not going to use a ball peen hammer. Use that. If you use a ball peen hammer like this, you're going to crush the ring. I mean, you don't want to do that. You only want to use this in certain situations. Like if you're tapping on the bottom of the shank, or you know, evening out the sides like we just did. So we're going to use a ball peen hammer to round this out a little better. rubber mallet. I may have called that a ball peen hammer. We're going to use a rubber mallet. My fault. Good for the most part. What we're going to do is get our inside ring smoother. Well, not smoother, it's the rock that we use to cut file down real fast the inside of the ring. I was fixing to change it. We still need to file down the top. Okay. Now we're going to set our wedge into our desk and we are going to file it the sides down even on both sides. And you don't want to push real hard. You just want to lightly just go over. If you crank down on it, you'll create a groove in the side of the ring. So you just want to lightly just keep forward motions like this, just like that. You don't want to go, you don't want to grind into it real hard, and you don't want to do this number. You just want to keep going forward. That's one side down. We're going to smooth out the inside just a little bit, or file it down just a little bit, because when you file down the sides, it can, when you file down the sides, you'll get a lip on the inside. So sometimes you got to file that down after you've filed down the sides. Still filing down here. We're going to smooth out the top a little bit more. Sir. Okay, now we're gonna smooth out the inside a little bit on this side, or file it down. Then we're going to take our file and do the top, kind of get these corners, these edges, kind of round them out a little bit. And you're using the same motion, just one very light across the top. And we're going to do that on both sides. Okay. Like so. And you can see we're now completely round. We're not oblong like we was. We're going to go ahead and turn our torch off here. And now we're going to go to our inside ring smoother. We're going to smooth down the inside. Get that done. Then we're going to go to our top side ring smoother, which I like to use the black, which is kind of like a medium grade. We're going to use that to file the top and the sides, or smooth it down. I don't know why I've got this all mixed up today. Using the file down is the smoother, and the smoother is the file down. We're going to be smoothing the top and the sides. Just one of them days, I guess. Okay, still filing down the top and the sides. Smoothing out the top and the sides. Man, I got this shit all screwed up. Still smoothing down the sides here. still smoothing out the sides and the top here. Now I do want to talk to you about something that I'm doing here. I'm not shitting on any other jewelers, because this happens to the best of us, but somebody's worked on this before, and when they pulled the solder through, they either got it too hot or didn't pull through all the way. There's actually a pit in this, in another section here, where somebody had soldered it before, but they got it too hot or didn't pull the solder all the way through. So there's actually pits. So I'm trying to file that down so that you don't see the pit. But it happens to the best of us. I'm gonna switch to a different smoothing wheel for a second here. Alright, now we're gonna switch back. Switch back to our other smoothing wheel here. Difference is this one's a little wider, the other one's a little narrower. We're almost there. We're almost there, we're getting there. Still trying to get that pit out from where it was soldered before. I'm not even really sure you guys can see that. It's very small, and you wouldn't really notice it unless you were looking for it, but still, it bothers me, so. And that happens too. Sometimes you'll drop it. Happens to the best of us. Still trying to get that pit out of here. Whoa. Yeah, this thing's been worked on a lot by somebody. Not me, but I don't know who did it before, but I don't know. I kind of question this. Gonna let my hand rest for a minute here. Yeah, I don't know I'm hoping I don't have to cut it and re-weld it back in that spot where they had it, but there's actually a pit right in there from where it was welded before and got too hot, or solder didn't pull through all the way, and it's bothering me. So if I can't get this pit out, I don't want to thin the shank out. I may have to cut it and re-solder it there too. let my hand rest for a second. I think we're gonna get this out without having to cut it again where it was, where they had welded it. All right, we're getting there. We're getting there, slowly but surely. We are getting there. I'll be back just a second, guys. Okay. That was quick. We're back. We're still working, guys. Still trying to get these poops out of there. I shouldn't even worry about them, but I do. Like I said, they're negligible. You know, they're not really that big of a deal, but they bother me, you know. So I want to get them out of there. sure them armrests are there. It's actually going numb. Crazy. Come on, dude. Come on, man. Come on. Alright guys, I think we pretty much got that thing out of there. Now we need to kind of round this thing out a little bit. Smooth out the rest of it. think we're almost getting there, hopefully now. I think we are pretty much where we're gonna be. Later on down the road, this thing's probably got a new shank. It looks like it's been fixed in here many a times. But you can see we're round now. We've about got the pit out. It's not very noticeable like it was. So we're just gonna file down the side, or smooth out the sides a little bit more. Then we'll clean and polish this thing up. All right, guys, you can see where, well, there you go. You can see that the ring is back together now. Now we just got to clean her and polish her up, and we'll come back and show you the finished product. And I know that that happens to some jewelers where the pits happen. That's usually from getting it too hot or not pulling the solder all the way through. But I understand that. But whoever did that made this a lot longer than it needed to be. So I'd have to say, go fuck yourself. I'm gonna go clean this up and I'll be right back. Alright, guys. Well, guess what? Let me see. Hang on just a second. Hold on, I'll be right back. Alright, guys. Well, guess what? We are back with that ring again. We had to go ahead and cut the bad piece out. There's a whole bad piece. Entire piece was bad. So we had to cut that piece out, and we're gonna have to put a new piece in. It's been welded so many times in that area, not by me, but by somebody else, that whole section is just bad. We're not gonna charge the store any extra to do this extra work. Because when they gave it to us, it just had to split shank. So I don't know who worked on this before, but all I gotta say is, man, you gave me one hell of a piece to work on, a crappy piece, something that should have been simple to fix has turned into a piece of shit. So that's okay though. We're gonna fix it right, get it done the right way. So we've had to cut that piece out. We done filed it down. We done got our gold piece stock here. I'm not sure if you can see that. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put it in there. We're gonna weld it on both sides, and then we're gonna have to file it down. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go ahead and put our piece in here like this. If it will go. Okay, and then we're going to put the ring on our third hand here. And we're going to have to flux in denatured alcohol, boric acid, that helps put a protective coating over the ring while it's getting hot. So go ahead and set this thing on fire. I really didn't want to have to cut it unless we absolutely had to, but that pit was just bothering me. Not only that, there was other pits starting to show up where it had been welded many times in that same spot. Either got too hot or didn't pull the solder all the way through. So we just gotta cut that piece out and be done with it. We are just gonna put a new piece in here. Okay, let's get this off the desk here. I don't want to grab that because it's hot right now. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna go ahead and put some flux on our piece, because we're gonna have to solder it on both sides here, like so. Now, this could also be a good title for how to size your ring up, but we're not doing that today. It's a little bit different process, so that'll be a different video. But this particular one, we just cut the bad piece out. We're going to put a new piece in, cut the excess off, and file it down. So we're going to grab some of our solder here. We're going to need two pieces, one for each side. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and weld both our sides here. To heat it up, get the flux flowing. And this is going to make the shank a lot thicker than what it originally was. So they're actually getting a hell of a job for not what it costs to do. But I'm one of those people. There we go, that side soldered. I'm one of those people that, you know, you brought it in, it was only cracked. That's what I charge you for. So I'm not going to charge you for the extra work that this is requiring. And shit like that's gonna happen. Okay, now both sides are soldered. So you can see, we got our new piece in there, and we got a lot of excess we gotta cut off there. But we're gonna go quench this into water real quick, which, for some reason, I don't have on my desk. So we're going to go ahead and quench that off. Alright, check, make sure our solder is pulled through on both sides, which it has. We're going to take a pair of clippers, and we're going to just cut this excess off that we got here. If we can. Sometimes you can't. Now we'll have to cut it a little bit with a cutting disc. We'll have to use a cutting disc to kind of cut it a little bit. Now we should be able to cut it. There we go, we cut our piece off. So now, you see we're not, don't have nearly as much hanging off there. Okay, now, we're gonna put this on the mandrel. We're gonna use our rubber mallet and try to round this out a little bit. Now we're using our bulking hammer a little bit. Remember, you can use that on the bottom or if you're trying to even out the sides. Okay. Now we're gonna file down the inside here. I'm kind of glad that this happened so that you can see that sometimes what looks like a simple repair, sometimes it doesn't always turn out that way. So now we're gonna file down the inside. Thank you. And now we're going to kind of file down the sides a little bit here. It gets hot, especially when you're filing down the middle. All right, now we made sure we checked the size on this before we put the piece in. Before we cut the piece out and put this piece in, because you want to make sure it's the same size as it was when, you know, before. So it was a 10, so we want to make sure it's a size 10, but you want to check that size before you cut the piece out, because if you cut the piece out and you didn't know what size it was, well, then you got a whole nother problem. Then you got to get the customer in, have them, you know, give you a finger size, or hopefully they know what it is already. Doing now is just beating on the bottom and getting this to a 10. And remember, you want to flip it over. You want it to be a 10 on both sides. Okay. Almost to a 10 here. We're going to use a rubber mallet to kind of tap the sides. We don't want to use a ball peen hammer on the sides because it's hollow. If you use a ball peen hammer on the sides, you will crush the ring in a microsecond. And then you are what I like to call. Okay, we're at a 10. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna file down the top, file the sides, get them even. File, kind of file this down a little bit, file the sides down even. And remember, you don't want to push real hard. You want to use same stroke motions. You don't want to go back and forth like this. Thank you. starting to look a little better here. And two, I'll be happier with it, because I really wasn't liking the pits that were showing up in there. And even though that's not my work that was done, could look bad on me, so better just to get it straight, take the hit. We're getting there. Almost. On this one side. Almost, almost. Okay, now we're going to file the inside down on this one side here. Okay, now we need to do the other side. Okay, we're getting there. Hopefully y'all are still hanging in there with me. I know some parts are probably boring, but a lot of these other jewelry places, they don't really show you the whole procedure. They only show you bits and pieces of it. This way you know exactly what to do and how long it can take and sometimes what can happen. You know, sometimes it just doesn't go the way it should. What was an easy repair turned out to take a little more work. But that's okay, that's like life, right? Sometimes things just don't go your way. And that's okay. Main thing is, as long as you keep moving forward, right? Right. Okay, we're gonna kind of quick file this one side a little bit here. Okay, now we're going to take the file, kind of round this top part off, because we did put a piece in there, so we want it to kind of blend in and kind of round off the rough edges on the top. Alright, let's see what size we got. We are a 10 on the money. So now we are going to smooth the inside of the ring here. Alright, we got the inside smoothed out. Now we're going to do the sides and top again. This is already looking much better. I'm a lot happier with this. Even though that wasn't my work, it was messing up or the welder many times, it bothered me. And now we'll do the other side. We got it all even, smoothed out. That looks much better. Much, much better. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go clean it, polish it, and then we'll come back and show you the finished product. All right, here's our finished product. As you can see, we got the practically new shank on there. We had to cut that piece out that was bad, where it had been worked on by somebody else so many different times. But now we got that back in order. We don't have that pit no more. It was bothering the crap out of me. And this is Rob the Jeweler, and I'll see you on the next one.